Hello, welcome back to another episode of the Virtual Ninja Show. My name is Heike and I have Mark back. We are going to talk about a unified sensor. We did an episode a couple of months, weeks ago where we talked about helping deploy Defender for Identity quicker, easier tips and tricks. And we mentioned something and we want to go deep today. Mark, introduce yourself and introduce quickly what we're going to talk about.
Hey, Heike. Hey, everyone. It's good to be back. So today we'll talk about the Defender for Identity sensor. This is the new sensor that, like you said, we talked about in the last session. But before we get into that, my name is Mark Thomas. I'm part of the customer experience engineering team, primarily working with Defender for Identity, really helping customers adopt Defender for Identity and get the most value out of the product.
So now I'm a little confused. You said a new sensor. So does it mean people then there's an old one and then there will be a new one and there is a migration, there's a new deployment? What can I think about a new sensor?
Essentially, yes, we've built a new sensor. So over the last year or so, we've been developing a new sensor, which is built into the Windows operating system. The whole idea here is to make the deployment and the operationalization of Defender for Identity as simple as possible. Having that agent built into the operating system, this allows us to do that.
So thinking about deploying it into the operating system, there comes a few challenges with it, right? Because you are dependent, obviously, on the release of Windows build. You also need to collaborate and work closely with the Windows team. Not that you don't do it for other deployment agents, but it's a little bit different. I went through this with Defender for Endpoint. Does it mean that we have something right now for the latest version of Windows? And then going forward, obviously, we will have to work with the lower builds to also get this running there?
Yeah, so today we have the new sensor built into server 2019 and above. So 2019, 2022, and now recently 2025. So the new sensor is there. And what this enables is new ways to use that sensor and activate that sensor as well. So this, if you're used to the classic agent, then you'd be aware that you had to download an agent, get that out onto the domain controllers and identity infrastructure. And that'll take time, and there were complexities in that deployment as well. Whereas now with the new sensor, it's in the operating system. All you really have to do is just activate, turn that on, and then that gives you the data we need for Defender for Identity.
Mm-hmm. And it's still the same that you need to not install it, but in this case, then turn it on, activate it on the main controller. So is there any other servers that this agent also has to be enabled?
Yep. So today we support domain controllers, again, running server 2019 and above. That's looking into the future of what we do next. So the idea is that we will have support for the other roles that we support, things like ADFS, ADCS, Entra, Connect servers. That's kind of coming, but where we are today, we have that support for domain controllers.
And how does it get updated? So if you keep developing, is that something that then happens somewhere else, or then you wait for a Windows update, or you have your own Patch Tuesday, Update Tuesday cycle? So how is this happening?
Great question. So we get this a lot from customers about the new sensor versus the old. Something we had in the classic sensor was what we call delayed updates, and this gave customers a bit of control around how they wanted to manage updates. Mm-hmm. With the new sensor, really we get the control to the customer because it's handled through the Windows update process. So as you update the Windows operating system on a monthly basis, ideally staying up to date and staying current, that's where you're going to get the latest benefits and updates within that. But really, this moves away of having a separate update channel. You can control it by just applying those monthly updates. Very similar to what we do with Defender for Endpoint.
I don't know if we talked about it in the last episode, but wasn't there a connection with Defender for Endpoint with the new sensor? Anything that we want to talk about here?
Yeah, so I think what we could do is jump into a demo, because actually one of the exciting things about the new sensor is it opens up these new ways of activating Defender for Identity. So basically, if you have a domain controller already onboarded to Defender for Endpoint, we can literally, within the portal, within a few clicks, say activate, and then it turns on everything we need for Defender for Identity.
Okay, let's have a look at the demo.
So this is the Defender XDR portal. If we come within Defender for Identity, you can see your list of sensors. What you did to onboard a classic sensor previously was add sensor. As you can see now, we give you the option. So as you come to add new sensors, we can either activate using the new method, which I'll show you, or you can continue with the classic sensor. And you may need the classic sensor for infrastructure like ADFS, ADCS today, or where you're onboarding things like Server 2016 machines.
And I think it's an important note, right? So the current applies to domain controllers running Windows and above, and onboarded to Defender for Endpoint. Okay, that's cool. Mm-hmm.
Correct. And when we're onboarded to Defender for Endpoint, what we can do is click Activate Servers. And what this will do is take you to this new activations area. So what these are in this list are domain controllers that are already onboarded to Defender for Endpoint, but haven't been onboarded to Defender for Identity yet.
Mm-hmm.
And what we can do within here is simply select a server, click Activate, and then that will activate the server. Basically, under the hood, turning on the sensor identity process and then sending the data that we need.
Beautiful.
The other key thing you'll see here is also we give the new sensor a version 3.0 or above. So a good way to tell whether you're using the classic sensor or the new sensor is looking at this version number. So you can see for the classic, we've got like 2.2.39. For the new sensor, we use the 3.0 versions.
Mm-hmm. So, and then I would assume that if you want to remove the sensor, you go through the sensor list, you mark the domain controllers that you want to remove it from, and then you click on delete, and then the sensor will be gone from that device again.
Correct. So yeah, you select the device, click delete. Uh-huh. This will only offboard the Defender for Identity component. If you did want to offboard it fully from Defender for whatever reason, you'd still have to run the Defender for Endpoint offboarding package to then fully remove Defender for Endpoint.
Cool. So tell me a little bit the thinking behind helping customers with Defender for Endpoint easier get onto Defender for Identity, or help Defender for Identity customers with the deployment or both of it. Like, what was the thinking for engineering behind that new sensor?
Yeah, essentially because the sensor is built into the operating system, similar to Defender for Endpoint. Really, these two components are sitting side by side within the operating system. So just having Defender for Endpoint onboarded already, really all we have to do is say, put down a new configuration and say, start sending the data that we require for Defender for Identity. So really, this was a really easy win to get customers from having something like Defender for Endpoint and then easily deploying Defender for Identity. We are working, though, on supporting customers that don't have Defender for Endpoint already onboarded. Mm-hmm. And this will look like a downloading an onboarding package very similar to Defender for Endpoint, but this will only onboard the components that we need for Defender for Identity.
And I know this is, the first version, and there is a huge roadmap ahead of us. So now that this is built into the operating system, do we also have other advantages that the other sensor didn't have or will have in the future? What's your take there?
Yeah, there's a few different advantages. So things like we used to have text-based logs with the classic sensor. These now live in the same place as Defender for Endpoint in the sense log. So looking in the sense log, this gives you the onboarding information, configuration information, those types of things. So having that all in the same place is useful. Also, it uses things like the same URLs as Defender for Endpoint. So we've kind of consolidated mm-hmm. what's required from a network point of view, that you can actually just use the same URLs for both Defender for Endpoint and Defender for Identity. And then one of the biggest things is what we call a new NNR capability. And that's something I'd like to talk about as well, because as we saw in the last session around Defender for Identity, network name resolution can be a pain point for some customers.
Yeah, let's jump into this, because I remember it. I was totally confused with all the things. So help us hear how the name resolution works with that new sensor.
Yep. So the new sensor, this really unlocks this new name resolution capability. So basically, in the classic sensor, to have name resolution working correctly, basically you have to enable the domain controller to be able to resolve IP addresses and host names within the network. This involves opening up ports across the whole environment between the domain controller and then out to wherever those devices are. And in large, complex organizations, this can be quite complex.
It was also weird protocols, right? It was NetFires and WINs or something, yeah.
Yep, correct. So really, with the new sensor, this is a lot more simplified. What we can do is, when we see the same authentication or event traffic hitting the domain controller, we may still only see an IP address in that data. But what we can do is we can use the device inventory within Defender. We know the machine through either device discovery or it's actually onboarded into Defender already. So therefore, we know the IP address, we know the host name, and what we can do is do that resolution on the cloud side rather than having to do that over the network. So again, this greatly simplifies that deployment.
So you mentioned going forward, customers are also asking to remove that dependency for Defender for Endpoint. How would then the name resolution look like?
So I can't share too much today, and maybe again, we can have a follow-up session in the future, but we are working on different ways to get that name resolution data. So ideally, you'd have a Defender for Endpoint deployment, but for those customers that don't, we want to support those. So we will have a name resolution solution for those customers as well.
Okay, perfect. What about the customers that have Defender for Identity fully deployed? Are we asking them to now migrate and move to the new sensor? Or is this more for customers that now want to enjoy Defender for Identity? What's our guidance here?
Yeah, so we really recommend the new sensor for new customers, also new customers that are well deployed in Defender for Endpoint. That's kind of where we are today. In the future, this is where we'll unlock those scenarios of moving the requirement for Defender for Endpoint. But for customers that are already deployed in Defender for Identity, we're really recommending they kind of stay where you are, because we are looking at migration scenarios. So we want to make this migration to the new sensor as seamless as possible. So having capabilities within the portal to help you migrate, getting from that old sensor or classic sensor into the new sensor, we want to give you the experiences to do that via the portal. So today, I think if you are deployed on the classic sensor, stay where you are for now until we have those migration guidance and scenarios.
So besides the deployment aspect, let's say the classic agent versus the new sensor, would the people that are moving to the new sensor or have the new sensor have more out of it? Like, do they, like, besides it's easier to manage, right? So you go and activate and then click, it's there. Do they have any other benefits, or can they say it's for now it's equal?
Yeah, so I think that there are benefits that we see with the new sensor. It's like you say, the activation. We see some from customers just managing one, essentially one agent. You know, it's MDE, it's MDI. We can update that in one go. We haven't got two different agents to manage in a way. So that management capability is a big thing. And then that name resolution as well. So as we can see, you know, name resolution, getting those ports open, those kind of complexities that we have, we don't have with the new sensor. So if you are really struggling with those kind of scenarios, you can look to consider the new sensor as a valid option.
So, and for customers that have Defender for Endpoint, Defender for Endpoint, but also Defender for Identity deployed, and they're installing a new domain controller, are we recommending to go with the, I don't want to call it the old agent, the classic sensor, or are we saying, hey, no, with this new domain controller, go and use the new one?
So from a security point of view, it's a good recommendation. And also things like the ease of deployment, the ease of manageability, it should be considered as a valid option for those new deployments.
Okay. And I think we will put links in the description on where people can read more about it. I wanted to say where they can download, but there is nothing to download. So where they can learn more about it. And I hope that many people will try it out. For those that don't have a Defender for Identity deployment today, go ahead and try it out. And for those that have already Defender for Identity deployment, look what you want to do in the future with the new sensor. Mark, any last words from you?
Yeah, I think just echoing what you said with Defender for Identity, don't wait to deploy. Get deploying now, either with the classic sensor or new sensor, because attackers aren't going to wait.
That's true. Okay, thank you so much, Mark, again for joining me on this episode. And thanks everyone for watching. Bye.
Look how he's looking there. And then we have the other one.